Politicians, corporations, bankers, lawyers, and even bishops have been using slaps to harass journalists, NGOs, and activists engaging in public participation, with the sole aim of draining them financially and psychologically in retaliation to exposing wrongdoing and criticism. The worst part is that our European legal systems still allow for this. Examples speak for the size and impact of slaps over our democracy. In Poland, politicians from the governing coalition, including the PiS leader Jarosław Kaczyński, have initiated over 55 slaps against one of the country's leading free media outlets, Gazeta Wyborcza. Last spring, Romanian journalists Ovidiu Vanghele, Vlad Stoicescu and Diana Onchoi were sued by a former bishop after revealing cases of sexual abuse in the church. In Malta, following Daphne Caruana Galizia's assassination, her family inherited over 40 slap suits, showing that abuse goes beyond death. Thousands of such examples can be given, usually coming together with huge financial claims, forum shopping, and years of pain. A mere recommendation or an act tackling or only cross-border slaps are simply not enough anymore. There may be limitations, but the EU has competence to address this issue. Our report identifies the legal basis to be used and sets out clear solutions. EU legislation must put an end to slaps, and the time to act is now. Us here together and every single member state. Thank you.